Happy holidays, family and friends. Welcome back. It's your girl, Miss Monificent here. Today, I am bringing you all a Dollar Tree DIY. I'm going to be showing you how I decorated three different types of Christmas trees that I purchased from the Dollar Tree. If this interests you, then please keep on watching. Okay, for the first project, I'm using this 9-tile board. 18-inch high Christmas tree. I'm using the green one. These individual garland strands. You get a pack of them. I'm not sure how many. E6000. A pair of scissors, or you can use wire cutters. I'm using this antique wax. You can use shoe polish. I'm also using hot glue gun and the hot glue sticks. And lastly, I'm using this craft floral foam. Okay, the first step is I'm going to be taking 5 of those 9-tile wood boards and I'm going to glue them together to make a box using my hot glue and E6000. Next, I'm going to be taking my dark antique wax. You can purchase this from Walmart. They also sell a smaller bottle. I believe it's like $1.67. This is some I already had, and I'm using this to stain my box. You can use shoe polish purchased from the Dollar Tree to make this project more cost effective. This is something that I already had on hand, so I'm just using some paper towel and I'm just going to go over my box. This is something that dries fairly quickly as well, so this is just going to give my box that stained look. Now you want to get the top sides of it as well, and this is what it looks like. Mine is pretty much dry, so I didn't want it, you know, to completely cover it. I wanted to have that wood stain effect. Next, I'm going to be taking this floral foam and I'm just going to take a big knife. You can use a utility knife or whatever that works for you, and I'm going to cut this to fit my box. Now I'm going to take my Christmas tree and I'm going to unscrew that little cap that holds the legs into it, because I'm not going to be using that. So I'm going to remove that. You just twist and give it a little pull and it comes right off, and I'm not going to be using the legs as well, so you can put all of that aside. Now I'm going to take my floral foam and the Christmas tree and I'm going to try to center it as best as possible, and I want to stick it down mostly all the way to the end of where the little wire stops. I'm measuring how much I need for it to stick out of the box, and you can just about screw it all the way down in there. Okay, now I'm just taking the tree and I'm just spreading the branches. Okay, so now let's make this tree look a little bit fuller. So now I'm going to be taking these individual garland strands. They match this tree almost to the T. So I'm just going to be cutting for the bottom branches. I'm going to be leaving at least about 1/3 of the piece. You want to leave a little bit more than the size of the branches for each one that you're going to wrap, because you want to leave room to wrap around that middle pole that the branches are wrapped on the original Christmas tree. So I'm just going to be doing that, and you'll see how I just take these and wrap them around that middle pole of the Christmas tree until I am satisfied with how full my tree looks. So I'm not going to talk through this. I'm just going to let the music play, and then you'll see the tree getting fuller.
Thank you.
Okay, now I'm going to stick my styrofoam in the tree down into my box. And now what I'm going to be doing is taking my individual garland strands and I'm going to be actually sticking them down into the styrofoam. So when I finish doing that, you won't even see the styrofoam. And this is my finished product. Now it looks so much fuller. You can't even tell it's the Dollar Tree Christmas tree. Now I'm going to go a step farther. This is totally optional, but I'm going to take this spray snow that I purchased from Dollar General for $1.75 and I'm going to spray my tree with this, and then once it's done I'm going to wrap some battery operated string LED lights around it. You can do whatever you would like to do with it, decorate it however you want. And this is what it turned out to look like. I absolutely love this. I really, really do. Like I said, it's your tree. Have fun with it. But let's move on to the next project. Now for this next project, I'm going to be using this roll of twine. I picked this up from Big Lot. I use this for other DIYs, but the Dollar Tree does sell twine. I did pick this cotton twine up from the Dollar Tree. I'm using jute twine and cotton twine. You're going to need your scissors, hot glue gun, and hot glue sticks. And lastly, one of Dollar Tree's Tinsel Christmas trees. Okay, we're going to do the same thing with this tree that we did with our reindeers. All you have to do is find you, just tug on the tinsel and then cut it and unwind. The Christmas tree was a lot easier than the reindeer was. So all I needed to do was snip one piece and unwind it. And this is what the frame looks like. Now I'm going to start with my cotton twine towards the top, and for the starter piece you always want to hot glue it, and this is the only time that you need the hot glue, because as you're wrapping this twine you're just going to wrap tightly and it will not unravel. I've already done this to a bigger tinsel tree that I had from last year. I purchased from somewhere else, but yeah, you just want to hot glue the beginning and the end of your twine. And you want to wrap and start as closely to the top as possible. Don't worry, you can come back to the top, which I do end up doing, but you want to just keep wrapping, making sure that you cover all of the black frame. Now I'm going in with my jute twine and I'm going to start a little bit above the cotton twine, again hot gluing the beginning and the end. This is just my preference. You can do this however you like. I think this is pretty much self-explanatory. Like I said, you just want to keep wrapping around and wrap tightly. You can wrap it this way or you can go up and downwards, but I think this way is a lot better because of the spikes. It holds a lot better. So this is where I've gotten to so far. I'm going to go ahead and finish this up and then I'll come back when I'm down to the bottom. Okay, once you get down towards the bottom, you will be using a little bit more hot glue just to secure it around the bottom of the frame. So I'll just, in different spots, I'll put hot glue and then I'll press the twine against the bottom of the frame. And that is how you complete your twine Christmas tree. Now I'm just taking my scissors and I'm cutting all the frayed ends off of the twine. You won't be able to get it really, really clean, but I'm trying to get as much of them as I can. Okay, and this step is totally optional, but I'm taking my Mod Podge and some glitter that I already had from Walmart, and I'm just randomly placing glitter onto my twine Christmas tree. For this one, I'm kind of going like it was a garland, and you'll see that in the finished product. And this is it for my Dollar Tree twine decorative Christmas tree. And right next to it, you can see the larger one that I have done. I really think these are cute and rustic, a little something different, and it was very inexpensive and easy to do. So now let's move on to the last project. For the next one, I'm going to be using one of these Dollar Tree wooden Christmas tree boards. I'm going to use this 30 sheets activity pad, and it has these three different colors in it. It's like shiplap. You have the red, the brownish tone, and then the whitish gray like tone. I'm going to be using this whitish gray like tone, some Mod Podge, sponge brush, and this glitter that I purchased from Walmart, but of course the Dollar Tree does sell glitter. And lastly, scissors. Okay, I'm going to start out with one of my sheets of paper and some Mod Podge. You want to measure where you want to put your paper. Of course, you want to have enough hangover so that you can fold it over. This one is basically self-explanatory as well. It took me, I believe, like 3 sheets of this paper. You want to line it up as, you know, even as possible. So I'm going to put Mod Podge on the board itself, press the paper on it, and then press Mod Podge over the paper. Now when you're doing this, you want to press down as firm as possible. Make sure you get all of the air bubbles out of it because it will wrinkle up on you. So I'm just pressing the Mod Podge over it, and then I'm going to flip the board over and I'm going to do a cutout so that I can fold the paper around to the back of the board. For each layer of paper, you want to line up these lines as even as possible so that the sheets won't look as separated. It might not be 100%, but it looks a lot better if you line the papers up. So again, same step, Mod Podge on the board and then Mod Podge on the paper. Now when I put the Mod Podge on the paper after it's placed on the board, I do dip my brush into glitter so that when it dries, it has that glitter effect already into it. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to continue to do this off camera, and then I'll come back and show you guys what it looks like when it's all done. So this is what it looks like while it is drying. I do see a few air bubbles, but yeah, this is what it looks like while it's drying. And then I want to show you one that I've done earlier. This one is already dry. I just added a little bit more glitter and wrote Merry Christmas on it. You can write whatever you want to do to it, put some decals on it. But I really hope you guys enjoy these today's projects. If you do, please give me a big thumbs up. I really, really appreciate it. Share me with your family and friends. If you are visiting, I ask that you stay a while by hitting that loyal button down below and turn on your notifications so you don't miss out on the fun. You guys have a great week, and I will see you guys in my next video. God bless.